Hi, beautiful people. How are ya? I hope you're having a great day.
With you, I can be sad with you. Just take my hand and fly up through the dreams where the skies are so clear.
I'm doing much better. I took it easy for several days.
I feel like I've kind of neglected my flowers out here. But boy, is this going to be pretty when it starts to bloom. I just watered it. And the other one is over here in front of this window. And they have blooms. I don't think they like that strong sunshine. But look how poor these are. They were really dry, so I picked as many of the flowers off. Busy road. And watered it.
Today is about fibromyalgia medications.
I barely see that one down there, but it's not doing too bad. It had some weeds in it that I had to pull.
I wanted to give you a rundown of what is out there.
What do you want? Why are you so cute? Well, are you telling me something? Are you telling me something? What, Tessa? What, Tessa? Treat jars up there. In that. Miss Baker, are you baking? Are you?
Are you baking?
All right, you come here. Come here. You prefer I throw it to you. You want to catch? You want to catch? She did it. I didn't quite catch it on camera, but Tesla. Sit. Good. Nat, sit. Good boy. Then he gets immediately up. Hey, pretty babies. I love you.
I just hope that you don't live in pain every day. I know that I tend to endure pain so that I don't have to be medicated, but sometimes it's necessary so that we can get things done and live our lives happily. Pain can cause us distress. And that can cause a vicious cycle of more pain. And that's not good for anybody. For most of us, it takes a while to figure out what works for us. But there is a lot that we can do. So we push forward. Here we go. SSRIs are antidepressants. I grouped this class of medication together because these are only prescribed off-label for fibromyalgia. The most commonly known SSRIs are Paxil or paroxetine, Prozac or fluoxetine, and Zoloft, sertraline. However, SSRIs have been used to treat the key symptoms of fibromyalgia, such as pain, fatigue, and sleep problems. And there's a growing evidence to support this, but there may be some bias. It works by treating depression in fibromyalgia due to the way neurotransmitters work in the brain. They have a small to moderate effect on pain. Thioglobenzaprine and tizanidine are two of the muscle relaxers that are used in fibromyalgia patients. Cyclobenzaprine, also called Flexeril, is a centrally acting muscle relaxant. It was first developed as an antipsychotic therapy. In one study, patients were three times more likely to report overall improvement, but there was no improvement on fatigue. In total, 85% of patients experience side effects. It can cause a risk of liver toxicity, skin lesions, and confusion. But it will help you sleep, and you may experience a decrease in symptoms. It's not effective in reducing muscle spasms, however. I can't take Flexeril because it makes me edgy and restless. And it's the only medication I can think of I've ever taken that gives me a strange reaction. For many people with fibro, it can relieve muscle tightness significantly. The big whammy is that Flexeril can cause addiction and withdrawal symptoms, so it should only be taken for short term. So for that, you might consider tizanidine. It works by blocking nerve impulses that are sent from the nerve endings in your body to your brain. It is effective in reducing muscle spasms and pain and helps you sleep. It also increases muscle tone, so it reduces muscle weakness and spasm. If you have liver or kidney disease, it shouldn't be taken, or if you are currently taking an oral contraceptive. NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, are sometimes prescribed for the management of fibro. NSAIDs are not found in research studies to be effective on fibro pain. If taken, use the lowest possible dose for the shortest possible time, like for an overlapping condition such as osteoarthritis. Acetaminophen, ibuprofen, and naproxen are often used in combination with other medication. NSAIDs are helpful with headaches and non-fibro pain to calm our system. With an analgesic and anti-inflammatory action, this is due to the inhibition of COX-2 so that a flare isn't experienced, but taking over a long period of time can cause heartburn or gastrointestinal issues because these meds inhibit COX-1 and lead to kidney or liver problems. NSAIDs can also cause fluid retention. I know that I took ibuprofen and naproxen back and forth over a long period of time, and I ended up getting silent GERD. I don't know for sure there's a connection there, but it has always made me wonder. But my warning to you is to take these medications only when needed, like for a headache or migraine, menstruation, sprain or strain, or a toothache. I didn't place aspirin on this list because some people take it to lower their risk of having a heart attack or stroke caused by a blood clot. And so follow your doctor's recommendation. For fibro, we're normally not prescribed aspirin. In the clinical world, a physician would not recommend steroids for your fibro pain. Steroids can only be taken a few times a year for a few days or a week at a time. So you would need to take something else the rest of the time. because once you go off the steroid, your pain will gradually come back. Maybe not as bad as it was, though. According to research, steroids like prednisone have been tested on people with fibromyalgia, and their symptoms didn't improve. But if they injected a steroid right into a muscle spasm or trigger point, it would work, even when other treatments failed. However, on drugs.com, user reviews, fibro patients rated prednisone at 8 out of 10. 71% had a positive experience, and only 11% had a negative experience. That rating is even higher than pregabalin at 6.4, duloxetine at 6.0, tramadol at 7.4, and pregabalin at 6.4. It's usually given at a low dose, and it's known that with long-term use, it can cause bone loss and osteoporosis. But many people with fibro say that when they take a steroid for another reason other than fibro, like a sinus infection or their arthritis pain, it makes their fibro pain worse. Let me say this, steroids make me feel energetic and alive when I'm in a flare. It doesn't exacerbate my fibro symptoms. Instead, I feel better. So everyone can have a different experience. The only one that beat that user review score was Guaifenesin, a cough and cold medicine that is off-label. You can purchase it at the pharmacy. It's called Mucinex. And this score was 8.5. But this med has also been shown in research to not be an effective treatment. However, there are plenty of patients who believe in this med based on the Guaifenesin protocol by Dr. Amand. The author of the research study, though, on Guaifenesin, Dr. Robert Bennett, maintains that none of the participants were using products containing phthalicidates during the study, and those who express their affinity to its benefits are getting a placebo effect, he says, and a heightened sense of control. So he's obviously not a believer in Mucinex as a treatment. But there is some evidence that Guaifenesin has muscle relaxant properties when used at higher doses. But research is needed, and at higher doses, there's a risk of kidney stones. So there's a limit to the amount of this med you should take. If you want to try this, please talk to your doctor first. So my final thoughts. There are other treatments like low-dose naltrexone and opioid antagonist. I did a whole video on this. Also, I've done videos on CBD, ketamine, and metformin. If you'd like to take a look at those, they're in a folder on my YouTube page labeled potential treatments. There's also topical meds, but I may do a separate video on those. I'm not sure. I know I use one. I like it. I don't know which medication is best for you. This is just a journey you'll have to take. It's a great talk with your doctor who should be able to help illuminate the issues concerning prescribed opioids and other meds and be able to suggest what might be best for you. Usually, there's an individualized approach to pharmacological management. Every fibro patient is different. And so therapy should be different too. So depending on your symptoms, your treatment should target those. In my opinion, if you find any of these to work, then that's all that matters. And I'm sure I missed other treatments. These are the major ones that stood out to me. What have you found to help your fibromyalgia? We'd love to hear from you. I hope you learned something. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you. As an antipsychotic therapy, if you have acetaminophen, we're now steroguanfacilisis, and what might
John?
Yep.
With you, I can't be sad. With you, just take my hand and fly up through the dreams where the skies are so clear. With you, I wanna stay with you.